Hello everyone and welcome to this tutorial. In today's video we'll be talking about masking text effects. In this type of masking we are going to put a text behind our subject. So if you are new on this channel, don't forget to hit on the subscribe button. Let's get into our work. I'm going to show you two possible ways on how to do that. The first method is to import your clip, to import your clip and your text at the top like this. Then you move on to the event pan crop. Make sure you select the masking tool. You mask out the text this way. Mask out the text. Try to zoom so that you can preview on your screen without any problem. And secondly, you select the same cursor so that it shows you the direction or the movement on your preview window. So that is the essential thing to do in this. So after masking your text like this, you are going to move to the next keyframe. Then you will do this, you pull this one and make sure it doesn't your subject, you pull it on at the point where your subject touches your text. Move on to the next keyframe and check to see if your subject touches your text. If not, go to the next keyframe until you find now that your subject is almost touching your subject. Or your subject is almost touching your text and the point, the exact point where it touches. Go to the next keyframe, do the same like this. Go to the next keyframe and to the same. This might not be accurate, but if you take much time, you're going to do that right up to the end. You see the way things are moving. Show that I'm keyframing point by point. And now, to make the text appear back behind whenever a subject crosses the text, you also need to duplicate that text. You need to duplicate your text this layer, so you're gonna move until the point where text supposed to appear like this. Copy this one, your main text layer, and you drop at the top and you start keyframe at the position where the subject crosses your text. Make sure to cancel all the keyframes of the first text that you just mask by selecting, click and drag on it. Once these keyframes you highlight, and then you hit delete before inputting your keyframes once again. This is what it's going to look like. And this, position it back at the start. Now you highlight, you mask out instead in this way. The mask is going to carry from behind because your subject is going ahead and your text has to move behind your subject. Now you're going to move this way to where you find the subject. So only your text has to be shown already as from this point. All you need to do is to make sure the subject starts where your text, I think somewhere here. If it is the case, you Having like this, you also be highlighting from behind. Make sure you don't like this. Then you add another keyframe. You still do this. Add another keyframe. And then do the same. You are going to do that until you are true to the last step. So that was the first method. Now the second method is also simple but difficult than this one. You need to duplicate your text. You need to duplicate your source text. Make sure this one lies at the top. And now you now want to, this time you are masking the object and not the text. Okay, mute this one so that we see through while in the event pancake of the muted layer. Make sure you position it until where the text, the subject starts touching the text, and then you add keyframes to it. Mask out the area of the subject like this. That one should take much time. Mask out the area below it. It's going to affect the text this way. That is it. Now add keyframes, move ahead when it touches the subject. Select this tool, the rectangle tool, move it a bit in front. Go one more keyframe again to the same. Don't drag it too much, make sure it slightly just cover the subject. Do the same. Until you meet. So it might not be accurate, but if you want it to look more accurate, then you need to take your time point by point. So I'll go to allow you finish sheet on your own. Now after masking, you have to unturn back, unmute back this layer. And now you see that you made a mistake somewhere here, because the subject is not, the text is not behind our subject here. So to correct that, you simply go back to the event bankrupt window and make sure at this point you pull. So that was how to mask out your text using Sony Vegas Pro 16 or any other. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe and share. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Like I said, this might not be accurate, but if you follow the steps as I just showed you, you won't be lost. I wish you the best and see you in the next tutorial.